Yeah, this is vegetative propagation for 10th class biology, and this is asexual reproduction. Here I gave the definition. It is an asexual reproduction by method of fragmentation and regeneration. Already we had seen this in the previous video. What is fragmentation and what is regeneration? Both I discussed in the previous video. So this is nothing but asexual reproduction. Here in plants we are seeing now vegetative propagation, and it includes layering and tissue culture. Even tissue culture is also included here. Actually, what is tissue culture means? We take some cells or some tissues from the plant and we grow them in the medium with all the plant hormones and all, so that we can get at a time number of new plants we get from the same plant. So this is production of number of saplings at a time. For that, tissue culture will be useful. And layering, here we learned what is natural vegetative propagation and artificial propagation. Okay, first, under natural propagation, it comes the leaf parts, like leaves, I mean the plant parts, leaves, stems, stolons. Actually, what are stolons means? Horizontal creeping creepers, actually, by producing roots along its length. This in our kitchen garden, we can see in the backyards and all, we can see that horizontally some plants will grow, like a chrysanthemum, that is for suckers, and mint, all these, they will horizontally they grow, they creep actually in the soil, and they will produce small adventitious roots. You can see that when we get this mint from market and all, we can see lateral adventitious roots. If you keep that in the under the soil, then we get the original stem, horizontal stem. Okay, from that wherever the adventitious roots are there near the nodes, from there new plant will grow. Okay, so these are come under stolon. So this is natural propagation that can be seen in the nature itself. And artificial, then artificial propagation, cutting, layering and grafting. This is naturally occurring in the environment, whereas this will be artificially we provide this so that to increase the propagation or increasing the asexual reproduction in plants. Okay, so here first one is natural. Under natural propagation, leaves also will take main part in the vegetative propagation. Example is bryophyllum. This bryophyllum you can see in the textbook also, once you can see. So leaves, bryophyllum is an example, and here you can see in the picture at the edges of the leaf blades, near the leaf blades, in the furrow like are there, no? From there actually new plant will rise. So this is in case of bryophyllum. So leaves, here with this example you can say that this is a natural propagation where leaves will take part. Okay, from the leaf blade or from the leaf edges, the new plants will grow. So this is asexual reproduction under natural propagation. Okay, then next coming to the stems. Okay, look at the board, all of you. Stems here, these are all aerial weak stems will come under this. Okay, and runners and stolons give adventitious roots at the nodules, grow into the new plants. Actually nodes are nodules. Okay, so here weak stemmed plants, all the weak stemmed plants, creepers, climbers, all you can see in the kitchen garden. Okay, so here these are very weak stems, so how they can sustain? By producing adventitious roots near the nodes. From there the new plant, from the nodes itself the adventitious roots will develop and new plant will be grown. Like these runners and stolons are helpful for the natural vegetative propagation. Then gradually they separate from the parent and develop as a new plant. I'll show you the diagrams also. First I'll explain here. So these new plants will separate from the main parent and then develop as a new plant. And here bulbs, onion example, calms, colocasia, tubers, potato, rhizome, ginger, root, moraya, that is curry leaf plant, karivepaku we say in Telugu, and stolon is the jasmine is example. Now I'll show you the diagrams and I explain you. So bulb is onion, bulbil is garlic. Okay, here this is a bulb, this is inside the soil, and here we can see the green leaf plant and branches and all. So gradually it develops into the new plant, and from here we can see number of bulbs. Okay, and tubers, this is potato example, and you can see the stem modification. Actually this is under the soil itself, and the leaves you can see at the top, and here at the bottom of the soil we can see these potatoes. From these potatoes, the eyes of these potatoes, the new plant will grow. Gradually bunches of potatoes we can see under the soil. And then stolon, here stolon jasmine is example, and here see the main plant is here. Gradually this is a stolon, in fact the long stem horizontally which grows is called a stem. stolen. Okay, this is very weak. And here, wherever it goes like this, at small intervals, it produces some adventitious roots like this. Okay, this from here, adventitious roots again, new plant will be developed. And this is the daughter plant, we can say. And gradually, this will be separated from the main plant. Okay, so here it grows into a new individual. So this is comes under stolen for the aerial roots. That is aerial roots or weak stemmed roots. And then you take kaam. Kaam is the colocasia is the example. You can see chamagadda you say. So this is kaam. And here adventitious roots are there at the down. And that will be at the bottom. And this is stem. And from here again the leaves, branches, everything will be developed. And here this once again here from here new adventitious roots will be developed. And bunches of colocasia you can see at the soil. This is kaam. This is also natural propagation. Now let us see artificial propagation. This is by cutting, layering, and then grafting. Okay, three methods. First, cutting. What is cutting means, you know, actually we cut the here I gave this. This is cutting and this is grafting. Okay, cutting. See, this is very common in rose. We can see rose. Actually, if you go to anyone's house and in the garden, if you see the rose, then immediately if you are interested, then we simply cut one of the stems and we are branches and we bring that and we sow in our sand and then soil, and then we get the new plant. So how this is happening actually, which type of stem or the stem part we have to select? A small piece of any vegetative part of a plant we can take. Okay, any vegetative part of a plant having one or more buds is used. Compulsory one or more buds should be there. Then we can take, we can select that part. Example, rose. In rose actually the stem part we can take. The stem itself, the branch, one of the branches we cut and we bring. Okay, like that cutting will be seen. And if you take bougainvillea, their leaf only we can take a leaf. And then we can sow in the soil. There we get bougainvillea. And then blackberry, if you take blackberry, root part should be cut. So like that, any different, any vegetative part of a plant can be used for a new plantation. This is by cutting. Then here, the easy method, just to induce the growth, we can use auxin. Auxin is the plant hormone. And to induce the growth, we can sprinkle that on the new plant so that we get easily the new plant. Okay, so this is by cutting. And then we see layering. Here, to propagate desirable plants, actually layering is to propagate with desirable plants. For example, you see here when a branch touches the soil, it produces adventitious roots. Actually, see the branch itself, for example, I'll show you the diagram so that you can understand. And the node of a branch is bent towards the ground and part of it is covered with moist soil. The tip of the branch is exposed. So here I'll show you in the textbook. You can open and see this. Nerium is an example, and even jasmine also we can take as an example for layering. This is layering. See, one of the branches is bent down, and this is near the node. We keep in the soil and we cover with some moist soil, and some part should be exposed. Here this is weak branch, and here this portion is exposed. So one of the branches we have selected, bent and kept in the soil and covered with moist soil. And this is a nodal portion. And from here, new plant will grow. Okay, gradually, this new plant will be separated from the parent plant, and it sustains and it develops its new life. Okay, leads its new life. So like this, in layering, we can see jasmine is one example for that. And if you take grafting, next one is grafting. Look at the board. Then I explain you what is grafting. Actually, two plants here join together, and the plant in the soil is called a stalk, and the cut part without roots is called a scion. Both are tied with twine thread and covered with polythene cover. We get desirable characters. Actually, I'll give you what is grafting. I explain you now. Here in the picture you can see, in the textbook you can see the diagram. Here the this is root part, and this is called as stalk, and the upper part, that is the stem part, is called as scion. Okay, here actually, see, when we want to have desirable characters, like sometimes one tree will have sweet fruits and one tree will have big size of fruits. So in order to get both the characters, then we go for this method of grafting. Okay, here we take the root part which is already fixed in the soil, and that part is the tip of that part will be cut, and instead of that we keep keep one more other desirable character of the plant, that is thiar part, that is a stem part, that will be attached here very tightly, and with the twine we tie it, then we cover it with the polythene cover. This is the wedge portion, like this V shapes you can see, so that the thiar part can be fixed very tightly. Then we tie with this twine, and then we cover it with the polythene cover, and then we allow it to grow. Then we get the desirable characters like big size sweet fruits. Okay, example is mango, we can say citrus, rose, and all these things we can get from this grafting. Okay, but here some disadvantages are there with grafting, because we cannot get new varieties, new characters cannot be induced, because this is not sexual reproduction, because this is asexual reproduction only. So that some disadvantages are there but at the same time we get the desirable characters in the fruit yield. Okay, so this is about grafting, and today in this video I discuss natural propagation and artificial propagation, which comes under asexual reproduction. So with this, plant propagation is completed. Thank you.